whatever it is, there's no problem that he cannot fix.
Welcome to House of Destiny. This is your boy, Dr. Charlie C.J. Jordan, a.k.a. Charles of the Ritz. Guys, I'm coming to you on this Thursday evening, praying that you have had a wonderful day and a wonderful week. Guys, I've titled this, Pending Doom, But Can You See? I wanted to start out with that particular song. That's a song that I wrote along with my family, my cousins. We wrote this song several years ago. It's called Turn It Over. Because, guys, I believe we've been hearing from different prophets about pending doom. We can already see what's taking place in Israel. And the things that are happening with Israel definitely is lining up with biblical prophecy, and it's lining up with the prophetic rhema word that God spoke through my mentor, our beloved prophet, Kim Clement. And so, guys, this week on Perspectives of the Prophetic, I'm coming on here to promote this, but also, like I've said many times before, I pray and I ask God, what is it that you want me to say on these Thursday evening lives here, live broadcasts here on not only Facebook, but we're shooting YouTube as well. What is it that you want me to say? And so God always places something upon my heart to give to you to help and really encourage you to stay the course. Don't worry. Yes, there is pending doom. No doubt about it. I heard a prophecy from Julie Green, prophetess Julie Green. Look, things are happening. God has been showing me that things are going to happen. Things are going to take place. Prophet Kim saw it. He saw it. Remember what he said to Obama. He said, Obama, if you do not have a captivating love for my people, Israel, for Israel, this will happen. This will happen. But God is saying right now through me again what he prophesied through Prophet Kim. Can you see? Can you see instead of looking and observing and being influenced by what is happening around us naturally? God doesn't want us to be moved by the things that are happening around us naturally. No, he quickens our spirit. He wants us to stay in his presence. He wants us to continue to trust him. Because how many times have you heard, especially from this ministry, from House of Destiny, that you are in a future and you look better than all of this that's going on? We have prophetic utterances, everybody, that solidifies how God feels about you and I, how he feels about this country, how he feels about the people on this earth, and how he really feels about the kingdom of darkness and those that practice the wickedness of the kingdom of darkness. So guys, you have to understand that he wants you to come into the light I'm going to play a very powerful video, and it's on my channel this week. I want you to go to Perspectives of the Prophetic, because this week, and I pre-record my broadcast for my channel, okay? And man, I just love how prophetic, how God is using me prophetically, because this week on my channel, it's titled, Can You See? God is talking about the very things that we are witnessing right now with Israel and the things that are going on around the world. Guys, let me tell you something. God is moving, and God has given us a promise. You and I, we are in the cleft of his rock, the cleft of the rock. Guys, if you can see it, you can truly be it. I want you guys to check out this prophecy. This is so powerful, and look, you're going to be totally blessed by it. Check it out.
I'm calling you. I'm calling you to come. I'm calling you to come. Calling you to come to the light. I'm calling you to come to my presence. I'm calling you to come to the light. I'm calling you to come to my presence. I'm calling you to come to my light. I will keep you under my sight. I'm calling you to come to my presence. I'll stand with you. I'll walk with you. I'll sing with you. I'll dance with you, says the Holy One. Indeed. Light. Doesn't matter how untidy I may be, but I'm prophesying light. I'm prophesying that there is light. If there were no light, then fear should strike you. If there was no refuge, then fear should strike you. But there is still light in this nation. There is still light upon the earth, says the Lord. What do I speak of? The light of my revelation, the light of my word, the light of my presence will cause your mountains to melt as wax before the presence of the Lord. Hear me, says the Lord. There is light, and light will protect you, but where are the people and the bearers of light? The bearers of light, says the Lord, as you praise, as you shout, as you pray throughout the earth, I will release more light, says the Lord, and it shall protect your highways and your byways. I will not need you to build walls, says the Lord. I will not need you to build walls. I am built a wall of protection, that Islam and its power shall not corrupt the children of this generation. Yes, radical Islam men have said, we will take your children's minds. God says, I say nay. I say nay. This shall not happen to my people, says the Lord. I have heard the affliction of my people Israel. Once again, I've heard the affliction of my people Israel. And now I'm raising up a banner, says the Lord. Yes, there is something I showed my prophet. I saw it, and I'll tell you what I saw. I saw the Hyatt Regency Hotel. It was not any other hotel. I was in it. I was on the 9th or the 10th floor. And suddenly the walls began to crumble down as there was a terror attack. I'm not sure of the city, but I think it could have been Chicago or that region. And the Spirit of the Lord said, even though this shall be something that is only brought upon by those that have been unrighteous, those who have rejected Israel, I told you, Mr. Obama, I told you, if you do not have a captivating love for my Israel, then there shall be death on your streets. There shall be bloodshed in America. But God said, I'm waiting to hear the sound of light. For there shall be bloodshed and there shall be more. But I shall hold back the terror that came on 9/11. For I have said to my prophet, there shall never be another 9/11 in your generation. Therefore those words shall stand, but terror shall be applied to those that have wasted my time. Therefore watch out, for God says, even though it shall be a strike, it shall not be successful, says the Lord. For many years ago in a Hyatt Regency, my prophet stood and prophesied, and yes, said the Lord, it did happen. But I raised up a man that stood against Islam. I raised up a man that stood against the war, against the nations that would come against Israel. Where is that man? I call for that man now, says the Lord. I call for that man again to come onto the scene and take the seat in the White House and be a noble president, says the Lord.
Come on.
Come on, just like Anna said. Come on. How powerful is that, everybody? How powerful is that? That word came on January 24th. 2015. And he said that he come to the light, because light overcomes the darkness. Remember that every song that we sung, every song that we played, when Prophet Kim and I and the team, when we were there at the den, every song was prophetic. We covered no other material. We didn't play Israel and New Breed. We didn't play Elevation music. We didn't play Bethel music. Nothing wrong with that. I'm not saying anything negative about that. Every song that we worshiped with, every song that we played and sung, was birthed in the Spirit, and it was prophetic. It was very prophetic. He said, come into that song, come to the place of light. Come to this place of refuge. That was a prophetic song that was born in that moment at that time. And God is saying through me and having you and I listen to it, but not only listen to it, but we are stepping into it. We are becoming the very song, the very words of that song. We are becoming exactly what that song is saying. We will come to the light. We have come to the light. We are within that light. That light covers us. And now protection is truly, truly happening. Hold on, everybody. This fan keeps trying to come on. And it's kind of weird when that happens. I don't know why this fan, so I'm gonna keep this like this, because it wants to come on and that drives me nuts. But anyway, that's my fan on my light up there. So anyway, but I want you guys to know this, that we are in the cleft of God's rock, and these pending dooms, this stuff that is, you heard it. You heard what Prophet Kim said. You heard it. It's going to happen. And then he said something about Mr. Obama. He said, Mr. Obama, what did I tell you? If you don't have a captivating love for my Israel, this would happen. So let me ask you once again before I tune out. Who do you think is calling the shots in D.C.? If you really think that it's President Joe Biden, no, he's not calling all the shots. Let me tell you guys something. We are in the middle of one of the most powerful moves of God. Did you hear what he said? He said, I'm waiting for this man, my David, to return. Where is this man? Because he was unrighteously removed. And we all know this. this David is returning. He's the one that's going to set in that place, that house called white. And he's going to be a man of prayer, full of the Spirit of God. Guys, get excited, because this is what I'm going to end with. God spoke this to me as I was putting this together. Can you see? For only the righteous can see in darkness. For darkness has truly come, and it will get darker, darker. But God says, for only the righteous can see in darkness. How? Because of my light, says the Lord. Darkness is all around you, but come to me, for I am the light. I need you to see. I need you to perceive, God says. I need you to obtain knowledge. Whose knowledge? His knowledge. He's saying, I need you to obtain my knowledge, my wisdom, so that you will faithfully navigate through all of this that is taking place. So come to me, for I want you to see, I want you to know, and I want you to understand, saith the Most High God. So guys, look, be encouraged. Be encouraged that though all of this stuff is ugly, all of this stuff looks like it's just going to get out of hand, but no, God has already told us that some of this stuff was going to happen. But he had a promise. He said 9/11 will never be repeated in this land. But they have planned something. Something is up. But God says, my light shall shine, and darkness cannot overshadow his light. So be encouraged, everyone. Know that you are truly somewhere in the future, and you look so much better than all this garbage that's going on around you. And when Jesus is in effect, Jesus is truly by our side, guys. We put that devil in check. I love you guys. This is the Ritz. Go to my channel. Can you see? This message this week will really, really bless you. Okay? I love you. Peace.
1, 2, 3, 4.